My name is Iris Franz, and today we're going to talk about market equilibrium. So remember, in the previous several videos, we talked about the market, and the market really is a group of buyers and sellers, and together they are going to determine equilibrium price and quantity. And together we're going to put together our demand and supply curve. Remember, demand tells you the story from the buyer side, and supply tells you the story from the seller side. Now together, they are going to determine market equilibrium. So what exactly is market equilibrium price? Here you can see your demand and supply schedule. Here is the price, and here is the quantity demanded. That's the demand schedule, and here is the quantity supplied, and that's the supply schedule. So you'll be able to draw the supply and demand curve using this schedule. And after you draw that, notice there is an intersection. And this intersection, you see the price is $3. And in fact, $3 is our equilibrium price. That's the price where you clear the market, meaning quantity demanded is equal to quantity supplied, meaning there is no shortage and there's no surplus. You have quantity demanded exactly equal to quantity supplied. So the market is cleared. So you will ask, what happens if our price is not equal to equilibrium price? Meaning, if your price is not $3, what would happen? So suppose your price is not $3, your price is $1 instead. So given the price $1, what is the quantity demanded? Now you will have to look at your demand curve in order to find quantity demanded. So given price is $1, you look at your quantity demanded, you look at your demand curve, ta-da, it's here. And the quantity demanded is 500. So that's your quantity demanded. And what about your quantity supply given price is $1? So you can look, that's $1, and then you look for your supply curve, ta-da, it's here, and the quantity supplied is 100. So you can see quantity demanded, 500, is not equal to quantity supplied, which is 100. So your quantity demanded is higher than quantity supplied, meaning we have a shortage. So when we have a shortage here, your shortage is equal to 500 minus 100, that gives you 400. So when your price is $1, you have a shortage in the amount of 400. And you do experience this in your daily life. So think about this. Sometimes Starbucks has this sales on Frappuccino, right? And they say Frappuccino is $1. Then what happens? You see a huge line in front of Starbucks. Everyone is trying to get a $1 Frappuccino. That's when you have a shortage. You have a big long line waiting for $1 Frappuccino. Or sometimes when you're trying to find an apartment and they say, sorry, we don't have an apartment for you, but we will put you on the waiting list. Now, when there's a waiting list, that also tells you you have a shortage. So you can't get what you want immediately. You have to wait. So that's a real life example of shortage. Now, what happens if the price is higher than equilibrium price? So suppose the price is not $3, the price is, say, $4 instead. Now, when your price is $4, your quantity supplied is also not equal to quantity demanded, meaning your market is not cleared. How do you know that? When the price is $4, you look at your quantity supplied. So you look at your supply curve, your quantity supplied is here, and that is 400. What about quantity demanded? Given the price is $4, you look at your demand curve, and you find quantity demanded is 200. So when the price is higher than equilibrium price, you can see your quantity supplied is higher than quantity demanded. So we say that we have a surplus. When your quantity supplied is higher than quantity demanded, we call that a surplus. And when the price is $4, your surplus is equal to 400 minus 200. That gives you 200 surplus. So I'm going to leave this as a homework. So write down in the comment below, what happens when your price is $5? Do you have a surplus or do you have a shortage? And how much is the shortage? How much is the surplus? In order to answer the question, you need to first find out what is quantity demanded when the price is $5. What is quantity supplied when the price is $5? So write down, when the price is $5, do we have a surplus or do we have a shortage? And also write down how much is the shortage or surplus. Write down in the comment, that's your homework. And also, if you find this video helpful to you, then please don't forget to subscribe and also share this video with others who are also learning economics. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.